Welcome, and thanks for joining me. I'm Timothy Sheriffs. This documentary will take us on an informative journey through the lives of teenagers, past and present. We will cover topics such as school, music and fashion, and what teenagers generally did and do for fun. We will also meet a range of people, from high up in the political scene to everyday parents and teenagers. So please, join me now as we take a look at schools and catch up with the Honourable Steve Maharey.
Teenagers have a life outside school, but they obviously at school get access to the education that's being provided.
What role do you see that schools play in a teenager's life?
Well, huge. Schools have an enormous influence on how young people see themselves, what they actually do in all sorts of things like sport, the kinds of friends they make, the way they see themselves. So something that has a huge influence on what a teenager will do.
Could you just give me a basic rundown of how the school certificate system worked?
Well, essentially it was an exam, a summation of the year's work, really.
What were the government's reasons from changing from the school certificate system to NCEA?
I think people just felt that the old system, examinations were put in place largely to sort young people out. So I think that the core change was from a sorting out system to a finding out what you know and how well you know it system.
We've all heard that girls and boys study differently. Did you create this system to accommodate for their different learning styles?
Yes, in a sense what you're trying to do is to move away from one size fits all approach. Maternal assessment gives a chance for people with different learning styles to learn in different ways, and the way we run the exam system means that different ability groups can stretch themselves or go as far as they want to.
Do you think NCEA is an easier or a fairer system than a school certificate for teenagers?
I think it's fairer. If you're a very able student, you probably skip through school C feeling pretty good. If you were a student that wasn't very able, you probably found it very hard. With NCEA, it's clearly fairer. You have a chance to show during the year what you can do in an internal assessment system. Then you also have the chance to sit an exam at the end of the year.
NCEA or school certificate?
School certificate sets me apart from the rest of the population more distinctly, as opposed to just getting an achieved a merit or an excellence.
School certificate, you got a mark. Now in NCEA you get a fail in a certain area, whereas in a school certificate I passed the whole thing, but I could well have failed in some areas.
I would rather do NCEA because you get to sit several assessments throughout the year which count towards your final mark.
I think I'd rather have done NCEA actually, because you can build those credits up.
Just to recap school, Mr. Maharey said that teenagers do have a life outside of school and that NCEA is a fairer system than school certificate, and feels very positive about its progress. Our teenagers and parents showed mixed agreement, some for NCEA and some against it. If both systems were somehow integrated, we would have a top class system. Music stretches back centuries, from baroque to hip-hop to doo-wop to Gregorian chants. In this segment, we're going to hear how the music preferences of teenagers has changed over the past 30 years. What sort of music do you listen to?
Pop, mainly, a bit of rock.
Modern music, like pop, hip-hop, R&B, a bit of classical.
Gangster rap and techno.
I do tend to listen to the old school music, such as the 80s and 70s music, and I do like the modern music.
I listen to rock, maybe a bit of indie stuff, new wave, just mainly modern music.
Do you like what your parents listen to?
Some of it.
Some of it. Some of it I find a bit weird.
It's alright.
Some of it.
But not a lot really.
Yes, I do.
Rolling Stones are quite good.
What sort of music did you listen to as a teenager?
I did like the Beatles, Beach Boys. I liked a lot of harmonies.
Classical music.
Mostly classical music.
The Beatles, that sort of stuff. The Who's, Dave DiDozzi, Beck and Mittentich, that sort of stuff. I don't know whether you remember that. Pop groups of the time.
ABBA and disco type music.
David Bowie. Neil Young.
Music. It's all opinion. But there was agreement on one point, that teenagers weren't overly fussed with their parents' music. I'm sure the feelings are mutual. Nowadays, fashion is a big part of a teenager's life. Wearing the right kind of clothes is important in a teenager's quest in trying to attract the opposite sex. In this part of the documentary, we will find out how important it was to look fashionable back then and also now.
Do you feel that looking good, as in what clothes you're wearing, is important nowadays?
Yes it is, because if you are looking good, then you feel good about yourself.
Yes, I think so. I think so that it's more important than when globalisation wasn't such a big factor.
Was it less important to look fashionable when your parents were teenagers?
Yes, I think so. But, yeah, I'd say so. But then I wasn't there.
No, I don't think so. They still wanted to look as good?
I don't think so. I think it was just as important as it is now.
I think it was about the same from what I've seen of my mum's pictures. But fashion's changed, so what we wear changes.
The fashion was different to what it is now. To look presentable has always been an important part of society, whatever generation.
Fashion is quite important these days. How important was it to look cool when you were a teenager?
It was very important. Looking cool was also being quite neat and tidy. The greatest invention in the fashion world was the miniskirt, and it was just the absolute best thing that was ever invented.
And it was very important.
Oh, very. We had to be up with the latest gears. The mini skirts and the hot pants and the boots.
Didn't mean much to me.
We were too worried about how much things were going to cost.
The general response on fashion was that it is important to look not necessarily fashionable, but tidy. However, it was interesting to see that not everyone thought fashion was important back in the good old days, where, from the parents' point of view, it was. Teenagers don't have much spare time these days because of school and other commitments. But here's what some like to do in their spare time.
What do you do for fun?
Go to the movies, hang out with friends.
Play sport. I like to use my cell phone. Talk to my friends, read.
Music. Make things in the garage.
I was a very keen reader.
I text, hang out with my friends.
Chase the cows.
Thanks for joining me. I hope this documentary has shown you, parents and teenagers, how each other feel about the topics we've covered tonight. We saw agreement and disagreement, and almost unanimously agreed that parents and teenagers will never really like the same music. I would like to thank all the families that helped me in my project, and for Mum, for everything really. And on that bombshell, good night.
You speak to me, I know this will be dead.